Hey everybody, and welcome back to another exciting and informative episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE. This episode kicks off the first in a series of repeater tutorials. Now about 4 years ago, I created a few tutorials on this topic, but a lot has changed since then. I also received some comments about how difficult some parts were to follow. See, I do read my comments and I adjust accordingly. Now everything that the repeater is capable of doing can't possibly be covered in one 7-minute tutorial. So over the next few episodes, we're gonna be learning all about this powerful After Effects feature. Now, if you're a serious motion graphic designer, you need to know how to use the repeater and understand its settings because it can be confusing. Even if you use the repeater on a regular basis, I highly encourage you to stick around because I guarantee you there's some tricks that you weren't aware of. Now come back for the next few tutorials and you'll be a repeater Jedi in no time. This episode is sponsored by the good people over at Envato Elements. Check them out today using the link in the description below and get an amazing 70% discount off your first month. Envato Elements has everything that a serious motion graphic designer could possibly want or need. And the best part is you get unlimited downloads with your membership. Check out their promo at the end of this tutorial and make sure to tell them that Jeff Knight from 7-Minute AE Tutorials sent you. Once you sign up, you won't remember how you ever designed motion graphics without Envato Elements. Please like this video so I can make that YouTube algorithm happy. Share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And remember to click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know if this tutorial helped you out. Hopefully, you learned something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers and is guaranteed to make you a shape layer wizard. The link to that course, to the amazing 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this episode are all in the description below. I've also included a table of contents so you can go back and rewatch sections that you found difficult. Okay, there's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's right click in this area to the left of our timeline, choose New Shape Layer. So if you just click this Add button right here, the first thing we have are groups. And then underneath that, we have our actual shapes, or you can do a path. Now, every shape layer has to have at least a fill or a stroke. And underneath our fills and strokes are all of our animation tools. There are quite a few animation tools you can use with shape layers. Today, we'll be using the repeater. We're going to add in a rectangle, and then let's add in a fill. And then finally, we want to add in our repeater. We're going to be creating a shape and using the repeater with no groups, meaning the only thing that we'll have in this shape layer is the shape, its fill, and the repeater. And you're very limited if you use the repeater in this way, but sometimes it's useful if you're going to do something that's a little bit simpler. Let's open up our repeater settings, and I've gone over this before, but all repeaters come in the same way. You always have 3 copies, and your position is always set to 100 on the X value and 0 on the Y. This is how many pixels away from the center point of your layer this shape layer is. We open up our transform properties down here. This is for the shape layer itself. Position is 960 by 540. The repeater has its own transform properties. And as we get into groups, you'll see that the group has its own transform properties. So it's very important to distinguish the difference between these different transform properties, how they interact with one another, and what they're used for. So for the repeater, this position is 100 pixels away from the center point of our layer and 0 on the Y value. So we want to change both of these to 0, 0. Now our shape is in the center of our layer here, and you can't see any of the copies because they're stacked. Now we need to add our copies. I'm going to start off with 12. And the way that the circle works is really this rotation on the repeater transform properties that is the key. Change this rotation degree value to 360, because that's how many degrees are in a circle, and you want to divide that by the number of copies you have. So say we have 12 copies, so 360 divided by 12, and that's going to make our perfect circle. Go back up here to our rectangle path, move the position of our rectangle path up. And it's really that simple. Whatever we do to the rectangle path size, so see if we make this smaller, it's going to affect all of the copies. So this is the most basic way to make a circle of shapes using the repeater. However, you are very, very limited. This would be good if you want to create like a burst, for example. So let's uncheck this constrained properties. That way we can adjust our size independently of one another. Right now it's 28 by 28. Let's make this X value 7, make the Y value 40. Put a keyframe on your position here. See how it's at negative 415. Move that forward maybe about a second and a half. Then just put this Y back to 0 at the start point. And let's right click keyframe assistant, ease in. And then I always like to have a hard ease in there. And watch it play back and kind of see this is the basic idea. There are a few ways you can fade this burst in and out. The easiest way is on your layer transform properties. Just put a keyframe for opacity, move it forward a little bit, make this zero. And then at the out point, you can highlight those, copy, paste. Then if you right click keyframe assistant, time reverse, and that will reverse the zero to 100%. So now it's 100 to 0%. And maybe we want to move this out a little bit. And you see, it's just a very basic little burst there. Maybe you want to increase the roundness of your rectangle path. There are some fancier ways to create this, but that's really the easiest way to do it. And this is really one of those instances where you don't really need to worry about groups. You can just kind of create this very simply using a rectangle path, a fill, and the repeater. And again, the main thing to keep in mind is you want to adjust your rotation. It has to be 360 divided by the number of copies you have. Right here, we see 12. Now, one of the things you can do that's very cool is let's change this rotation back to zero. And as you can see, our circle goes away. But now we can Option or Alt click on rotation, type 360 divided by, and then take this pick whip right here. This is your expression pick whip, and just pick whip up to copies. Okay, so see now we have 12. If you change this to say 15, it will update automatically. Change it to 8, and it will always stay in a perfect circle. So this is one shortcut that you may want to do. It will always remain in a perfect circle. If you wanted to group this now, you will have an issue. So say, let's close all this up, go to contents, and let's add a group. So now say if we wanted to bring all of this within a group, it's going to break our expression. So just remember, if you do that, you have to go back into your repeater, go back down to your rotation, and then just simply redo that expression. So it's 360 divided by and go up to your copies. But that is actually a really cool shortcut. I use that quite often, 360 divided by and pick whip up to my copies, and then I can change that to whatever I want, and it will always stay in a perfect circle. You're very limited by not grouping this if you want to do something that's a little bit more interesting. So I'm going to take off these keyframes right here, and let's just make this back to where it's a rectangle. I'm going to constrain that. It looks like a circle now because our roundness is set so high. So let me just put this back to zero. And I also want to take all this outside of this group. Let's delete that group and open up our repeater settings. And I'm going to just fix this expression real quick, 360 divided by, and we'll pick up to our copies. You can run into issues if you want to add anything else to this animation. Say, what if I wanted an ellipse that's on a stroke? If we go back to contents and let's add in an ellipse. And keep in mind that with shape layers, everything works from the bottom up. So this repeater and this fill is affecting everything above it, meaning this ellipse and this rectangle. And we don't necessarily want that. We want the ellipse to have a stroke. You could move the ellipse path underneath the repeater. And let's add in a stroke. And now you have to move the stroke underneath. Say, if we want this ellipse path to be like a line that goes underneath these shapes, well, we have to increase the size of our stroke, but notice that the stroke is also affecting the rectangle. And again, that's because with shape layers, everything works from the bottom up. So this stroke is affecting this rectangle as well. And we don't really want that. The easiest way to get around this issue, and something that I highly recommend whenever you're using the repeater, always use groups. And we'll go over that topic next week. One of the things to take note of, let's go ahead and take off this ellipse and this stroke. If I wanted to rotate each one of these rectangle paths, there's no option to rotate. If I rotate my layer, it's going to rotate all of them as a unit, but we can't rotate each individual rectangle. The one shape that's different is a polystar. So let's bring this polystar up here, take off this rectangle. Now the polystar path, this has more options than rectangles and ellipses. So let's move this position up. So you actually have this control over outer and inner radius, so you can control the size of it. But now you can also rotate this, and it's going to rotate each individual copy, and that way it rotates in place. Well, you don't have that option with rectangles. And with ellipses, it doesn't really matter, because if you're using a perfect circle, the rotation doesn't matter. But the main thing to remember is that if you're using a polystar path, and this goes for star or for polygon, we'll give this three sides. You can control the rotation of each copy so they rotate in place, but with rectangles, you can't do that. What I recommend is to always use groups whenever you're using the repeater, and we'll go over that topic next week. Until then, remember to always set your repeater position to zero on the X and Y values, and then use the formula on your repeater's rotation, 360 divided by the number of copies you have. Or use the expression 360 divided by and then pick whip your expression up to the copies. Just remember, if you group your repeater after you use this expression, the expression will break. So you need to reset it once the repeater is placed inside of another group. And the last step to create your circle of shapes is to move the position of your shape path up or to a negative Y value. However, when you use groups, you'll want to adjust this position value at the group level, not the shape level. Come back next week to learn all about why grouping is the best practice when using the repeater. I want to thank Envato Elements for sponsoring this episode, and also thank my viewers for making this sponsorship possible. For designers, editors, and animators, Envato Elements is an amazing resource. With your membership, you can download unlimited assets for anything you could possibly want or need for your projects. Get access to high-res stock videos and photos, as well as motion graphic templates for titles, video displays, logo animations, lower thirds, infographics, promos, openers, and so much more. You also get access to backgrounds, textures, patterns, and icons, which we all know are vital resources. You get access to music for your sound beds in virtually any style or genre you can possibly imagine for designing the perfect sound for your projects. Speaking of sound design, you have access to Envato Elements' entire sound effects database, which includes any sound you could possibly need or want for anything from short film production to commercials to logo stingers. Every asset comes with commercial and non-commercial licensing at no extra cost, so both you and your clients can produce amazing projects with peace of mind. And again, with your membership, you get unlimited downloads of all of these assets from Envato Elements. Download as much as you want, as often as you want, without ever having to pay for individual projects or files. Check out Envato Elements from the link in the description below and get 70% off the first month. That means you have access to everything from Envato Elements for less than $10. It's an unbelievable deal, and I highly recommend you check it out. I hope this tutorial helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. And click the bell so that way you're notified every time I upload a new video. Please share this episode and my channel with your fellow motion graphic designers so they can become After Effects rock stars just like us. And please, leave me a message in the comments below and let me know what you learned from this episode. Hopefully you picked up something new and useful. Sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers. It's a comprehensive course that covers literally every aspect of shape layers, and it's guaranteed to make you a shape layer master. The link to that course, to the amazing 70% discount from Envato Elements, and the project file for this episode are all in the description below. Come back next week for another repeater tutorial so you can hone your motion graphic Jedi skills. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.